Hey, seventh grade, just wanted to share with you what we were going to, completing the, adding the source. So we are on the thing that says new student, okay? You'll come up to the top, you'll be on dashboard, but you want to come up to the top where it says sources, and we're going to click the green button that says create new citation. And we said this morning that it was website, and a web page from a website, because remember we looked at student activities, which is a web page on the Woodstock Middle School site. All right, so I'm going to go tabbing back and forth. So I'm looking for my URL first. And notice that if I click it, it'll tell you what it needs. So I'm going to click back up here on student activities. If I click it, it's going to highlight the URL. I can use the Control C to copy, or I can right click and I can hit the copy here. I'm going back to sources and I'm putting the URL right in there. Okay? I hit Control V in order to get that in there. If we look down at the bottom, we need the date of publication. And we said we didn't see one right here. So we were going to look at all the way at the bottom. We can see that it's 2018. So I've got the 2018. And we're going to look at the recent date of access. So if something changed, we could say, well, we saw it today. So I clicked the word today, and all of a sudden, it populated with the August 15th, which is today's date. We did not have any authors there, so we're leaving that blank. Okay, right? Remember, usually an author will be underneath the web page title. But we need the web page. And we said the web page title is student activities. So I'm going to type that on there. All right, and the name of the website, we said, is Woodstock Middle School. And the publisher of the site, we said, was down at the very bottom next to the copyright date. And I'm just going to go ahead and highlight it and use it. Cherokee County School District, I'm going to use my Control C to copy it and my Control V to paste it. And then I'm going to click save. Really important to click save so that way it's going to show up. And you'll see whenever you begin a citation and it doesn't have an author, it's going to begin with the quotation marks. Normally, if you do have an author, it's going to say the author's last name right here. But it starts with student activities in quotation marks. Then you have italics for the website. Here's the publisher, the date, the URL. Okay, and you notice it's super long because we want the whole address to get to that student activities page. And then when we got there, if we need to fix something, all you need to do is click edit, options, and then edit. And when you're ready to do a next citation, you're just going to click next. You're going to go to your next website and your next web page, and you're ready to go again, just filling in all the blanks. I hope you have a good day.